Omobolade, do you have menstrual cramps?
Yes, I do have menstrual
cramps. Like regularly?
Yes, dysmenorrhea. Not as regular as I see other people see, but I do have menstrual cramps.
What do you do?
So, interesting question, I must say. Menstrual cramps sometimes for me comes, sometimes it doesn't.
Okay.
But when it does, what I do is my first home remedy is to boil water.
Mm.
Hot water is my first go-to.
Yeah.
I drink hot water, but well, not so hot, but something that I can actually
somewhere
drink.
In between.
Yeah,
a little bit more than warm shower.
Yeah, but more hot than warm.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I drink hot water, and of course I get either, if I don't have like a water, so there's this hot water bottle that people use for, not a flask, there's a hot water bottle that has a rubber coating. Mm. So people use that to, you know, put it around their
belly, and all of that.
And so if you don't, so sometimes I might not be able to reach for my hot water bottle depending on where I am at the moment.
Yeah.
But if I'm able to boil water and then get like a towel, so I do hot compress.
Mm, interesting.
With, what's it called? Or if I can get water in a bottle just to make sure that there's heat around my abdominal area. That's what I do most of the time. I don't use drugs for...
I know, right?
I use drugs for my menstrual cramps, but... anywhere I can get hot water. And I also engage in activity, a lot of activities to distract myself. Because most times when I am focusing on the pain, I get weighed down. But if I'm working or I'm doing a lot of things, I would realize that I'm not pain. Yes, I would be in pain, but I'm not focusing on it. So it's not as much as, you know, when I am putting all of my attention into it. But there are times whereby... no matter how much I'm working,
no matter
at some
the distraction.
Point, I just have to, like, sit down. And I also make sure that I eat.
So that's one thing about menstrual cramps. I don't know, but for me, it takes away the appetite completely.
I am telling you.
Like, I won't be able to eat. I won't feel hungry at that moment. Mm-hmm. And, okay, so for me, what I do is, like you said, just hot water. I will not lie. I don't engage in any activities because... at that moment, okay, so you know the pain differs from what you... okay, so I really cannot weigh your own, you know, menstrual cramp because you might... I don't know how you might be feeling.
Mm.
But to a large extent, for me, it hurts. You know, yes, we feel the pain at lower abdomen and all, but it affects my thigh, my back.
My back, yes.
Headache and all of that. So you can imagine
body pain.
Then you can imagine now doing other activities with that. In fact, that would be the last thing that would come to mind, you know. And like you said, at times, yes, it's very... what I do is I see movies. But, no, I've tried. It doesn't work. The only thing that works for me is when I take the hot water and I fall asleep. So I'm sleeping away the pain. That's
when
what
you
works
wake
for
up,
me.
What happens?
So that's the tricky part. When I wake up, it depends on the number of hours
that you sleep for.
So when I wake up, it's reduced. It's always reduced.
That's cool.
It's not always as much as... of course, the pain will still be there, but it's not always as much as before I slept.
You know, some people actually experience dysmenorrhea higher than other people. Some people's pain. So I used to have a friend that... whenever it is that she's about to have menstrual cramps or when she's about to menstruate, she's always dreading it. In fact, not just her, we are always dreading it because it is very terrible. Like, you know, at some point, you'll be wondering that, is it not the same
what
that's happening? But then hers is way bad.
Like,
she's always extremely ill. Like, there's vomiting. There is a lot of pain, a lot of agony. And, you know, it just makes me realize that you can never understand, you know, how
someone
it works
else's,
for
how
it works for somebody else. Because, I mean, I have met somebody that said they don't experience pain at all.
Yes, I have.
And
so
that's
and
just
like,
strange to me. I'm like, really? Like, they have never experienced pain even once. And I'm like, oh, okay. But how about some people that experience massive pain and some people that experience mild pain and some people that don't experience pain at all? It's just different categories,
people,
really.
Yeah.
But what is really important is know your body and know what works for you. And that's one of the reasons why we'll be running through home remedies for menstrual cramps this morning. We want you to know what it is and what you can do when you experience menstrual cramps in your home. And another thing is, I mean, we want to make sure that you are doing the right things and you're keeping safe, mm-hmm, and you're eating healthy.
Yes, that's
another
thing.
You know, I was saying something
important about
eating earlier.
Yeah.
And the reason why I said that is because you are losing blood.
Yes.
Yeah. You are actually losing blood. So you actually need energy. So it has happened to me where I was experiencing menstrual cramps. I was, in fact, that was a very, very, very painful menstrual cramp. I remember very clearly about 2-3 years ago. Very painful. And I had a lot of work to do. So I didn't eat because I needed to work. I was trying to distract myself,
yeah,
and all of that. And I was losing more blood,
yeah,
because, you know, when you're doing a lot of activities, I don't know if it is scientific, but you tend to have more blood running out of
but
your
I think
system
that,
and all
okay,
that.
I don't know, but for, you know, for some people that, yes, see the, they experience the pain first day, second day. Well, I don't know. I just feel like, you know, at that moment when the blood is flowing, it's cool, actually, if it's just coming out, like, because, okay, it's different. Like I said, it's different from, for, you know,
yeah,
a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
For me, the moment the first day, like, it's heavy, the next day, it's
light,
you know, light,
nah,
and all. And by the third day,
not
I'm
me.
Almost done.
Do you, no, do you know that some people, so now, some people have 3 days, some people have five days.
Some people have 1 week.
Yes, exactly.
And, okay, so at times I used to wonder if it's normal, actually.
To have 7 days. Yeah, I think it is normal. So there's a 28-day cycle that you have to run through. So the only time it is abnormal is when it's outside the 28-day cycle. So, you know, there's a calendar. If,
yeah,
you have this app on your phone, there's a calendar. So if you talk to, thank goodness we're going to be having
a guest
that will be breaking all of this down,
mm-hmm,
for us this morning. But according to what I know is, it gets irregular when it's outside the 28-day cycle and all of that. So some people, when so for instance, If you're having hormonal imbalance and all of that, your dates can change.
Mm.
You know, for some people, you have regular dates and from the 15th.
That's when you see, like,
every month, you know, so you're,
yeah,
always prepared.
Yeah.
But then you realize that on the 15th, it didn't come. You did not engage in any sexual
activity
whatsoever.
Yeah.
But it didn't come on the 15th. It didn't come on the 16th. Okay, I think that's still normal because I think your cycle is about to change to something else. So sometimes some people have irregular cycles where it comes on the 15th, you don't know when it's coming again, or the 20th, you see.
Yeah,
then
that's
true. Again, it comes back on the 1st, and you know, all
you know,
of
it's
this
like
thing
that
is quite
changes.
Irregular,
mm-hmm,
and all of that. And I'm guessing it's because of the person's hormones. Probably something is changing in their body system. They changed environments, food, and
is
all that of
that. Is that okay, though?
But
because I think I have that too.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Something that you should actually know why it is happening. Maybe that your body is changing, something is happening, or maybe it's your eating pattern
It could actually be.
But anyways, we're going to move into the home remedies that you should take when you're experiencing menstrual cramps. And the first one is drink water. If you know me, you know that I'm a huge fan of always,
mm-hmm,
drinking water. And bloating can cause discomfort and make menstrual cramps worse. So drinking water can reduce bloating during your period and alleviate some of the pain it causes. Also, drinking hot water can increase blood flow throughout your body and relax your muscles. This can lessen cramps caused by uterine contractions.
Mm.
I am a big fan of drinking
Hot
water during if I'm experiencing menstrual cramps, because somehow it makes me feel warm. There's this warmth
actually
that comes with it, because at that moment, all I am looking for is relief.
Mm-hmm.
Anything that can give me relief whatsoever is what I am looking for. So, you know, if I drink warm water, it actually makes me feel warm and relaxed. And of course, I already have the hot water bottle by my abdominal area. So I'm already putting that around there just to make sure that I am feeling better. And I'm always rubbing it around my stomach. Yeah. Rubbing it around my stomach. Because, you know, this dysmenorrhea can be so painful.
Yes, actually.
And, you know, all you are looking for is, how can I get this out of my system? You know, there was a time when I was younger, I used to ask my parents, what have I done?
Well, let me share my very first experience. When I first saw it, I thought I was going to die. Like, I thought I was going to die. It came with serious pain. I was legit rolling on the floor, you know, vomiting, having to use the restroom at the same time. Like, so many things. It was just happening too fast, you know. And I felt like, I was even asking, because I think I was saying my grams then. I was asking her, is this the end? Am I going to bed? And she's like, no, don't worry. And I actually noticed, for me, painkillers don't work at all.
Interesting.
I am telling you, painkillers don't work. And I've also noticed that when I force myself to use painkillers, the next time I would see it, the pain will be like times two.
Interesting.
So I try as much as I can to avoid painkillers, using drugs when I'm experiencing menstrual cramp. But yeah, like you said, of course, I feel like, in fact, the quickest way to, you know, ease menstrual cramp is to increase your, you know, water intake, your
yes,
water intake. And I like the fact that you mentioned the hot bottle water that you always,
exactly.
You know, so there's something about our body. We have this heat receptor. The moment it is turned on, it kind of reduces the pain, you know. So for menstrual cramp, it's always like that. So the pain gets more severe whenever the uterus contracts. The blood is unable to, you know, easy passage of the blood. That is, the blood doesn't go out easily. So when you, what hot water does is it melts,
Your uterus. Yes. It actually melts it.
It melts everything.
Have you ever felt, like, you know, when you drink warm water or you actually have hot water around your area, do you feel it melt?
Yes.
There is that feeling that you get. So we're not trying to creep you out this morning, but we're also trying to, you know, explain some of these things because, I mean, this is for everybody. And also for husbands and partners and and moms and sisters, so you know, understand how some of your children are feeling, some of your wives, your partners, whatever it is, so you understand how they're feeling. Because, you know, sometimes if you are not in somebody's shoes, you cannot, you cannot understand.
You won't understand.
You see, I mean, it is so interesting that, you know, how you're feeling at a time is definitely different from how I'm feeling. I might be going through menstruation at the same time, or menstrual cramps. It's a question I want to ask the guests, though. You know this thing where you're in the same, a space with somebody.
Yeah.
For instance, three people.
Okay.
Their dates are different.
Yes.
You have menstruation, and then all of a sudden, every other person has it.
Okay, it's a weird thing. Yes, it's actually weird, and I've only heard it from you, Omobolade, but
it's a very
weird thing. I think it has happened before, where I was staying with some group of friends. Of course, the days where we had different days, but that particular day, we were all on at the same time. And in my mind, I was like, okay.
Somebody turned on the tap.
Yeah. I mean, but then again, we also like, you know, you to call in on the show. What are the home remedies? What do you do, you know, whenever you're feeling menstrual cramp? What are the things you use? What are the things you use to basically ease the pain? We'd really like to know. As Omobolade and I were basically sharing our experience, and we'd like to know what you do to ease the pain. And so, yes, we said warm water, very, very key.
Yeah.
As, trust me, that's like the quickest way to, you know, ease the cramp. Mm-hmm. Also, I would advise bathing with hot water.
You know, some people don't like to bathe with hot water, and I find those people very strange. If you don't like to bathe with hot water, I find you strange. Really strange. Because I feel like it is just wickedness. You bathing with cold water. Especially,
you know, the water
in the
does
morning.
Not okay, okay. So I've heard, I don't know how true it is, that when you constantly bathe with, what's it called now, hot water, it wrinkles your skin or something or makes you age quickly. I don't know.
I just feel like whatever it is that bathes with cold water.
I feel like it's normal. Where it becomes weird is when there is Harmattan. Weather is extremely cold, and then you're still bathing with cold water. And I'm like, okay. So now I'm scared of you.
Yeah. I have a friend that does that. All she does is bathe with cold water. Either Harmattan or winter or whatever.
And people still gonna sleep on that AC.
Serious cold water. And I'm like, you are wicked. That's all. Is wickedness.
How is the wickedness of Obola?
I feel like if you're not me or wicked, you would not be bathing with cold water. I said what I said.
What about those that now chew like malaria drugs? Like chew it.
Wickedness.
Okay, so the people that bathe with cold water, they are wicked.
Evil. That's another level. Like, how do you know how bitter anti-malaria drugs are? Do you know how bitter it is? With the nins and nins that are inside, and then you chew it.
Yeah.
Oh, same as people that actually drink herbs like straight on.
That one is even better, really.
Trust me, you cannot
compare malaria drugs with all of this about this.
I'm not talking about the herbal mixtures that they mix with soda
or
carbonated drinks.
I'm talking about the natural herbal drink
that they brought from the
I would rather take that. So I found an act to it. So if you want to take something like that, just hold your nose like this, right? And then gulp it. Like you're gulping it.
We get that.
By the time you're done, that's when you start feeling it. But at the moment you're gulping it, trust me, you don't feel it. Compared to those that they're actually chewing malaria drug, this one you're feeling everything.
Do you know there's this hack that you can do. When I was younger, but I don't do it anymore. I think I should start doing it again. When they give you drugs, but they know that you don't want to use it, so they will make sure they make solid food for you.
Yeah, they'll now put it
or pounded yam. So they just put it inside for you, so you wouldn't know that you have taken your drug and then you eat it with soup.
I've tried it so many times, and let me just let you know that I chew eba. I chew swallows,
guys. But anyways, let's move on to the next one that we have this morning.
And this one says, enjoy about teas. I mean, about teas have anti-inflammatory properties and anti-spasmodic compounds that can reduce the muscle spasm in the uterus that cause cramping. Drinking chamomile, fennel or ginger tea is an easy, natural way to relieve menstrual cramp. Plus, herbal tea have other benefits like stress relief and helping with insomnia. Yeah, this is actually very true.
This next one says, eat inflammatory foods. Now, some foods can offer natural relief for cramps and they taste great. Anti-inflammatory foods can help promote blood flow and relax your uterus. These include berries, tomatoes, pineapples, and spices like turmeric, ginger, or garlic. Leafy green vegetables are also something that we should look into. Almonds, walnuts, and fatty fish like salmon can also help reduce inflammation.
And this next one says, skip the treats.
Why? Yes.
Well, you're soon about to find out. While a brownie or French fries might sound delicious, food high in sugar, trans fat, and salt can cause bloating and inflammation, which makes muscle pain and cramps worse. Grab a banana or another piece of fruit to fight sugar cravings, or go to unsalted nuts if you want something more savory. I agree. Yeah. So a lot of people will say, you often realize that when people complain about the menstrual cramp and all, the first question is, have you been taking a lot of sugar?
Well, I thought, so there was this notion that I had But you know, sometimes when you are having menstrual cramps, you crave for sugary things.
And yes, you crave for sweets.
You crave for carbonated drinks. You crave for chocolate.
You crave for all of these things.
So now, interestingly, it is not good for you.
Yeah. Wow. Yes, it is not. And I know you're Mobolade because you're a lover of cake.
Yes.
Yes. I love maybe cake. Chocolate too. I don't know, but
I
cake.
I enjoy chocolate. I love cake.
And this is that you say that you used to look for distraction. And yes, you do that. But every time you say you look for distraction, aside the exercise, are you sure you don't eat cake? She has answered my question.
So there was a time.
Yes. Story. I'm trying.
No, seriously. Okay. There was a time that I would indulge myself in red velvet cake.
Every time you're experiencing menstrual cramps.
I am telling you.
Right.
Like,
you
so
see?
There was this spot that I had. And all that I did was go. They know me. In fact, at some point, when they see me coming, they know what I want. Like, they already know what I need. And their red velvet cake was so delicious and very fluffy.
Yeah.
Like, I loved it so much. But, you know, I had to stop. So
if I was your mom and I see you eating velvet cake, and later you're complaining of menstrual cramp, you know what I'll tell you?
What? See?
Unfair. Because, I mean, sugar actually, to be honest, to a large extent, sugar actually increases.
It contributes to
you know, the pain and all of that.
If they're experiencing this, you don't know because you wouldn't see anything. Some people are, you'd already know the moment you see that their face is filled with acne or their mouth is puffy or their eyes is red and all of these things. So majorly, all we're just saying is there are some homemade remedies that you should try. But if you're experiencing severe dysmenorrhea, I think it's time for you to actually talk to your doctor. Stop doing what you're doing and talk to a physician, somebody that can actually help you.